Hi, we're back on the shtick with Serge Thomann, talking about Mirka.
Here.
You're still here. You're wearing the
Mirka
Morris scarf.
Mirka scarf. What can I say?
Yeah.
I've got three scarves, and they are all three a Mirka Mora or Gorman scarves, which are
they're Gorman scarves.
They're very rare.
And on Sunday, I met the lady.
Yes.
What's her first name?
Lisa Gorman.
Lisa Gorman. What a gorgeous lady.
Yes.
So they've transposed.
They used
the art onto clothing.
Correct.
And, which is brilliant.
So they did it twice. So
yeah.
And it sold out every time the scarf sold out in half a day.
Yeah. And we've got the dress at the exhibition that Julia Zemiro wore at the memorial.
Correct.
Which is beautiful. That's coming up as an image now in front of the screen.
And I shouldn't be saying that, but that's the dress Mirka was wearing in her coffin.
Really? Mm. What?
That dress, that design of the dress.
The design, not that particular dress.
Not that dress, but she was, that
wow.
Because obviously that was what she was wearing when she left us.
Amazing. So the culture of Mirka Mora will live on. You were just telling me about you're going to try and get a statue of
yes,
Mirka.
Yes, but I think obviously Mirka lived most of her life in StKilda.
Yep.
And then she, obviously, we got Tolarno with all the murals there, and
yes.
We've got the mosaic at the pier. We've got stuff, at Cosmos. It used to be Cosmos readings.
Yes, and for the street station, of course.
Yes, but I'm trying to talk about the StKilda.
StKilda,
and you've got a few other bits and pieces.
We want to get a statue of her sitting in the middle of that fabulous.
Correct. I want the statue.
That's a map of StKilda. It's eternal.
It's a map of StKilda, and originally it's a seat that was underneath that. Rotunda.
Yes, I know. What happened to
it's
the rotunda?
No, it wasn't part the new design of the beach. It was not part, it was...
Because I really like that rotunda. I think they should bring it back.
It didn't fit with the old thing. But as
what?
I said, what it was, it wasn't just a mosaic. It was a seat.
Yeah.
Underneath, right in the middle of the rotunda.
There was.
For people to sit on it and to look at the bay. And Mirka spent a lot of time. She's done, she didn't do many paintings on site, but she has done one of the pier, more or less, from there.
Yeah.
In 1967 or something, or 64. And I think... We want to have more of Mirka in...
Talking about Mirka, you've got a fabulous dog. How do you spell Sia?
Sia, like the singer, S-I-A.
Sia.
Goddess of wisdom and knowledge. So come
Sia. That's what dogs are for.
Come here, Sia. So when I actually got Sia as a pup, I went, Sia likes company, and we used to take her to Mirka, at Casper Care, where she was at Emerald Hill in South Melbourne when she was in aged care.
Yeah.
The first time Mirka saw her, she said, "I want a dog like this." And in a way, I've sort of gave her my dog. And I said, "The day you are no longer with us, I'll just take her back." So in a way... Yeah. In my mind, and every time we used to go to see Mirka, she used to jump on her bed unless she was obviously sleeping, and there was this lovely. Sia used to lick her neck, and I said, for me in my mind it was it's a little bit Mirka's dog. She never had a dog. She had lots of cats.
Yep.
She had Pompon, who was a massive cat. That she used to carry. She used to. Promenade Pompon in her pram through StKilda or Richmond, but Sia was a little bit her dog, and she's a French bulldog, so she's a Frenchie. So Mirka can have a little Frenchie.
So we had a really good time in our lives. It's been great since Mirka passed away. It hasn't been the same.
No,
really.
It hasn't been the same, but at the same time. I say the way people have remembered her and all that kind of sympathy and all that love, that outpouring of love. It wasn't an outpouring of grief. It was an outpouring of love.
Yes, I know. It was a celebration of life. That
and it was very unique. The service, people were, it was a joyful memorial. It was obviously Julia Zemiro has got a good sense of humor and a good sense of timing. She did a terrific job as the MC.
Yeah.
Everybody who spoke.
And all three boys, Philip spoke beautifully.
Absolutely, Philip, Thierry, and Lily, and of course Lily.
Of course, the granddaughter was fabulous.
And everybody, and Guy Grossi, and
yes,
the Heidi people, and Carol Gartner. So that all the different things, and obviously the premiere. So I think the way people spoke and addressed Mirka's legacy in different ways. And then you got the performances. You know, it was great to have a bit of Edith
Kate
Piaf
Sobrano.
And Kate Sobrano. I said we picked
with Paul Grabowski.
But I said we picked. Mirka came with four records.
Yes.
And
Edith Piaf. Yeah. What else?
Vivaldi,
of course.
Four Seasons.
Yes.
Ray Charles. And Aretha Franklin.
Oh.
And so we didn't.
Oh, I'm getting shivers on my shivers.
That's
now.
Right. So we did not. Obviously, we didn't know how to write Charles. We didn't know how to remember him. But
hit the road, Jack.
But we did have the other three. So
we have to get out of here. So we'll be back.
Can I come back?
You can come back sometime, but we'll
not
have to
next
find
week. Not the week after.
No, in sometime in the future. But I'll be back the week after next with some more shtick. It's been really great to have you, Serge.
Thank you. It was a pleasure and a privilege.
Great memory. Get down to Heidi Gallery or whatever it's called,
free.
The museum. It's free. And thanks, Amit, for putting up with the dog. we're having
up.
A late.
Say goodbye.
The late, late show. Bye, see ya.
Bye,
shake hands.
Bye-bye, see ya.
Bye, see ya. Say a wave.
She needs a piece of wood. Now, baby, say, for my dude.